Good morning everyone. Today we'll be discussing about the concept of the various layers in the OSI model. There are 7 layers in the OSI model. One of them is physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, session layer, presentation layer and application layer. So only 4 of them we will be dealing today. The remaining I'll be dealing it tomorrow. So what is a physical layer? Physical layer, it's nothing but medium which you are using to transmit your data. The medium is nothing but a wire medium or a wireless medium. Okay, wireless mediums, it's like a radio waves, it may be the Wi-Fi's, it may be various other aspects, it may be satellites. All those are the wireless medium. Wired means there are different types of wires, coaxial cables, the copper wire cables, you have optical fibers, these and all come under the wired cable. So in this concept only, what and all things are being maintained, what and all things are said to be necessary for the data to be transmitted through the physical layer, that it will be learned today. So what is physical layer? In the physical layer, it has various functions to do. So functions is nothing but one of the function is, it is bit representation. Okay, bit representation is nothing but your data, it will be represented in the format of bits. Okay, bits are nothing but how the bits are being transmitted over the data. Bits are nothing but, okay, your data, when it is said to be in the waved format, it will be in the formats of zeros and ones. The data, it will be transmitted when it is 0 and 1. When the data is being transmitted, one bit transmitted, then it will be 1. If the bit is not transmitted, it will become 0. So those signals, it will be transmitted over the wire in the electric medium or through the optical signals which are said to be generated. Okay, when it is said to be signals generated, though it is said to be digitalized, even in when it is audio type, it will be in this way. The signals, it will be generated, it will be also having the zeros and ones only which are being transmitted over the line. Okay, so that is said to be our bit representation. The bit, it will be in the format of zeros and one. And next one is transmission rate. It's nothing but how the data is being transmitted over the line. Okay, when one wave is being generated, at what rate the wave gets transmitted. For example, 1 second, 2 seconds, like that the data gets transmitted. So that is said to be your transmission rate. Whereas physical characteristics, as I said, the transmission mediums which are being used, wired or wireless mediums, those are said to be the physical characteristics. Whereas the synchronization, when the data is being transmitted, okay, all these over, so the synchronization is nothing but when the data is being transmitted, the sender and the receiver, the sender who is said to be sending, he should be having the waveforms in the same format, but the receiver also, it will be having the waveforms of the same format. For example, here it is normal format and here it is doubled wave format. Too many signals here, the disturbance occurs. So some problem is there at the receiver's end. So synchronization, it will not be there. Synchronization is nothing but both the ends, it should be transmitting of the same types of signals. And the transmission mode, when the data is being transmitted, it will be either simplex, half duplex, full duplex. That we have learned in the previous classes, what is simplex. One mode of transmission, half duplex, one at a time it can send. And a full duplex, both the end it can transmit. That is transmission mode. Whereas the physical topology is nothing but you have learned about the various topologies. So it will be following the topologies in the physical layer, the ring topology, star, mesh, bus topology. So all those it will be followed in the physical layer. So all these are the functions of the physical layer. So what is the diagram says? You can see when a transmission medium is there, through which your data, it will be transmitted, it is in the binary format and accepted by the data link layer in the binary format only, either zeros or ones. Okay, so this is physical layer. Next we move on to a layer called as data link layer. Data link layer has its own characteristics. Data link layer is nothing but your whatever data you have got, it has to be linked from one device to another device. That is being done by the data link. Mainly when it is linking the data, all your data, you all know your data, it will be in the bigger format. If this is a bigger data, it will divide into multiple small, okay, multiple small blocks it will be divided. when it is dividing into small blocks, these have their own characteristics and workings to be done, and your data, it will be in the format of units, it will be transmitted and received, and that is called as framing. Whereas physical addressing is nothing but each block whichever it is there, it will be addressed in a separate address form. If it is 100, one block, another may be 101, 102, like that, it will be addressed separately, and these may execute in its own way. First it may execute 101, it may execute later 100, because of the data which is being carried, one may be faster, one may be slower, but at the end it will be reassembled back and it will be sent to the other. So physical addressing is nothing but the source and the destination, it has to be addressed properly. This in the beginning it becomes source and this is destination, afterwards this becomes source and this becomes destination, like that each level it will be having its own source and destination. Next, it is said to be your flow control. Flow control is nothing but when the data is being transmitted, the data is to be flowed in a slower way. Okay, your data, it shouldn't be moving from one end to another end in a faster way, it should be moving in a slower way, one by one, so that the receiver also, it can receive in a proper way. Overflow, it shouldn't happen. And error control is nothing but if any error exists in any of the frames, then that error, it should be cleared then and there only, without any damage, without any problem. If a damage is there, then it has to resend back the data, and once again it has to get back the data before it is set to be reaching to the main destination. Okay, that is the part of your data link layer. Remember, here also it has its own function. One is framing. It has its own functions. Framing, physical addressing, flow control, and error control are there in the data link layer. Okay, this is how the data link layer happens. Here you have the trailer. Trailer is nothing but previously from where the data is being got, and trailer, next trailer where the data is going, that is there. Here you have the frames. It will be sent one after the other from one layer to another layer. From data link layer, you are said to be getting the data from physical layer to data link layer. From data link layer, it will be moving on to the network layer. Like that, it will be passing from one layer to another layer. This is your data link layer. Okay. And next one is your network layer. Network layer has its own function. Okay, main aspect of the network layer is to deliver whatever packets are there. You all know your data gets divided into multiple packets. Like this, the packets, it will be divided and it has its own addressing format. And this packets, how it will be delivered from source to destination, that main aspect, it is being covered by the network layer. Okay, before delivering, it has to find out the route also. Route means what? Okay, when I am moving, when I am going from one end to another end, if one route is proper, I will be passing through that route. If any problem is there in this route, I will be following a different route, any of the different routes. So that route, it should be rectified and it will be transmitting the data over that particular route. Okay, that main function is being done by the network layer, and network layer is responsible for mainly the delivery of the individual packet from one end to another end in a proper way, without any mistake, without any disturbance in the packet. That main task is being taken care by the network. Okay, so this is your third layer. Then after that, next layer, this is your network layer. What happens here is, like, you have the, here also you have the return, have the trailer, beginning trailer, it will be having the ender trailer, it is moving to the next part from one end to another, that it will be there. So your network layer, it, from transport layer, data link layer, to from data link layer to your transport layer, it will, okay. And you have the network layer here only, within that layer it will be transferred to the network layer. Okay, the next part is your transport layer. Transport layer is nothing but how the data is being transmitted over the line. Okay, when the transport layer, it is said to be doing the work, the main aspect of the transport layer, you can see here, responsible for source to destination deliver for entire message. Okay, network layer, what does it do? It links from one source to destination, it finds out the route and transmits the data. Whereas transport layer, what does it do? The entire message is being transmitted by the main transport layer. Entire message is nothing but it is not in packets it will be transmitting. It will be transmitting the whole data into the destination, from source to destination. Okay, before that you have many steps. Okay, earlier the data has been segmented. Segmentation means what? Your data is being divided into multiple smaller units. That smaller units, okay, this it is said to be having small units. So they may have executed in this order 1, 2, 3, 4, like this. But at the end, when it is said to be received, it has to be in the proper format, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. So this should be maintained, and this it will be maintained by the transport layer, that it is delivered to the other end in a proper way. And at the end, it does the segmentation and reassembling, plus it will be doing the error control. When it is transmitting, when it is not in the proper format of 1, 2, 3, 4, it check out whether where it is having the problem, it retransmits the data and gets back the data and delivers to the destination. So remember, the transport layer, it will transmit the entire data to the destination. That is the part of your transport layer. Okay. So this is your transport layer. You can see here, you have various layers from where you are said to be getting the data. What you are said to be doing is, you are said to be getting the data from all the layers. What do you do is, you get the data, it is in the multiple formats, in multiple bits, multiple packets it will be having. Okay, those packets it will be received and it will be transmitted to the upper layer without any problem. So that work it is being done by the transport layer. It gets the data from the application layer. Okay, from application layer it will be moving on to the network layer. From network layer, what happens is, it is said to be once again transmitting to the application layer. So this way the transportation happens from one layer to another layer, another layer to another layer, but it will be there in the full-fledged form. Okay, thank you.